a special if that happens. Hell yeah, I'll do a 2-hour special if that happens. We're going to get into a ramble on football. Football on a ramble. This is what you get every Friday here on the channel from now on throughout the year. It's been a lot going on. We had FA Cup third round over the weekend. We had Man United getting their arses whooped against Man City last night. 3-1 at home in the Carabao Cup. But it's okay. We won the second half 1-0. That's all that matters. We have Liverpool beating Everton with kids. Well, mostly kids, an inexperienced side. It was bloody ridiculous on Everton's part. We have some transfer rumours. We have Ashley Young apparently on his way to Inter Milan. Can United even afford to lose Ashley Young right now? I find myself asking myself this question. Can United honestly afford to lose Ashley Young? And I think, are you off your bloody bonkers brain, Ollie? Why are you asking yourself that question? But then I remember, Ollie relies on Ashley Young every week, whether he's right back, left back, sometimes on the left wing, which is was his natural position. It's absolutely nuts. I mean, Inter seem to be the club where we send all our unwanted property to. Yeah, Lukaku, bugger off. Sanchez, yeah, he can have him. Ashley Young, well, why not? Nemanja Matic, go on then. What about Phil friggin' Jones? I'd rather keep Ashley Young for the next 10 years, till he's 44, than have Phil Jones play another game for United. What is wrong with our club? Does he have something over us? Is he the illegitimate son of Sir Alex Ferguson, the man who said he'd be like the best signing United ever made in 10 years? That's what he said when he signed him. He will be one of United's best ever players. Christ, Fergie must have been on the red wine that day. Right, let's get straight to this. Jurgen Klopp played the kids against Everton. I saw the lineups. I backed Everton on a bet. I thought Everton were finally going to win here. First time in like 20 years at Anfield that they'll get a victory. Did they? Hell, Everton obviously missed that script. Wasted a lot of chances in the first half. Liverpool, Curtis Jones, young kid, has got a great goal in the second half. A game that Liverpool did not want to win. That's why they put out the weakened side. They've gone on and won. Imagine if Jurgen Klopp manages to win the FA Cup without even wanting to. If he just picks his inexperienced team and they just keep winning and winning all the way to the final. And then they beat Man United or something in the final. If United can get past Wolves, that is. I mean, he didn't care about the League Cup, so he was happy to go out of that. And that's why he took all the best players to Dubai, or Qatar, wherever the hell it was, to play in the World Club Championships. He won that. He sent the kids over to Villa to go out of that competition. FA Cup, he wants to rest players, put out a weakened side, and they win. So Klopp can't do any wrong at the minute. He's on the verge of winning the Premier League. They've pretty much won it already, haven't they? He's got the FA Cup on the roll. He's got the, in the Champions League, he's got Atletico Madrid. Is that correct? I do have it wrote down somewhere. Let me have a look. I'm pretty sure it's Atletico. Yep, Atletico Madrid. I predict Liverpool get past them over two legs. Atletico are not the team they were 4 or 5 years ago. So, Liverpool are on a roll right now, and you can't stop them, unfortunately. Mane won African Player of the Year last night. It was between him, Salah and Mahrez. Mahrez hadn't really done enough of the year to win it. Salah's form has dropped off. Mane just kicked on. So, rather so, he won African Player of the Year. I reckon Phil Jones should have won it myself, but apparently he's not African enough. Now, Jose Mourinho, is he starting to realise just how deep the issues are at Tottenham? I mean, it's one thing going into a new club and thinking, right, okay, we need X, Y and Z brought in. But you've got to get rid of A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P first. I mean, it's just a little look at the players who either want to go or he might want to get rid of. Eric Dyer, bag of wank. Sorry guys for my language, what a load of crap. I Bayern Sessegnon, who after the game against Bayern Munich when Sessegnon scored on his debut for Tottenham. Jose was asked, do you see him as a left back? He said, no, not in the Premier League. He's not strong enough to be a left back. Yeah, where's he playing the last couple of games? Left back. So Danny Rose to go, Eric Dyer to go. Lo Celso, they've got him on loan from Villarreal, is it? Or Betis? Betis. With an option to sign on a permanent deal. I don't think Jose will want to spend that money on Lo Celso. He will not have seen enough of this kid to think he's worth sticking around. And Ndombele started fantastically when he first came into Spurs. But Jose has decided Ndombele is his bitch. He's like, every chance he gets, he calls him out. No, Ndombele did not want to play today. He told me he's not fit enough to play, so he not play. Do I think he should have played? Yes, he should have played. He should have played with a broken leg. Then he picked him the other day against, was it against Middlesbrough? Or was it the game before that? I'm struggling to remember. There was a game anyway I watched the other day at Spurs. And Ndombele was picked. And he went off with an injury. Early on. And Jose didn't even speak to him as he passed him on the touchline. He was just like, get out my face. Get out my pub. And Ndombele, if it was Peggy Mitchell anyway. Eric Lamela, he brings him on. He brought him on against Middlesbrough. Don't really know what he expected to get from Lamela. Load of waffle. He's a one-trick pony. He'll get you a few goals a season. He'll have two good games, six bad games. So, he's got to go. 1-5. I thought this kid was half decent a season ago. Lost his way a bit. I don't think he's a Mourinho type player. Got to go. Hugo Lloris out of a broken shoulder. He's probably thinking, okay, I don't trust Gazzaniga, but I trust Lloris even less. I've seen him over the last couple of years. I reckon he'll need a new goalkeeper. And then there's Christian Eriksen, who we all know wants to leave. Apparently Inter in talks from at the minute. If Eriksen runs down his contract and goes on a free at the end of the season, I hope he's hounded down in the street and egged, because that is a shitty way to run down your contract and do that. My honest opinion, players should not be allowed to leave on a free unless it is agreed by the club and the player. If the club says, look, we don't think we'll get much for you, you've given us good service, we're prepared to let you go on a free, that's fine. But no way in hell should a player be allowed of Eriksen's stature to leave on a free transfer because he wants a nice payday at the end of his contract. Where Inter, Juve, whoever, probably Juve, they'll have a free transfer. We'll give him a shitload of money to sign and they don't have to pay Tottenham anything. That is bang out of order in my opinion. What else we got going on here? Who is good enough at Man United? I wrote this down, I don't know why. I went with De Gea, Maguire, Lindelof, Wan-Bissaka, Luke Shaw. Hang on, I've got to clear my throat. Scott McTominay, Fred, Rashford, Martial, Greenwood, Dan James, Williams, Duin Zabi, and Chong, or Chongi as socialists call him. Who is not good enough? Phil Jones, Eric Bailly, Ashley Young, Paul Pogba, Juan Mata, Nemanja Matic, Jesse Lingard, Andres Pereira, Diego Dalot, Fosu Mensah, Gomez, and Garner. That's what I wrote down. Am I starting to change this opinion? Well, after last night, I'm a little bit. Apparently United were prepared to offer $45 million and Jesse Lingard for James Maddison. Now, if I was Leicester, I'd be saying, I want $90 million, $100 million, and you can keep Lingard. We'll even pay you to keep him. How the hell this lad gets anywhere near the United team, I'll never know. He has a few good games a season, a couple of good games, and then it's just all about his bloody own celebrity status. I'm not a fan of Jesse Lingard. He's just swapped us agents to Pogba's Mino Raiola. He's the new agent of Jesse Lingard. They're welcome to him. If that's his way of getting out of the club, please just go right now. Can United really afford to play Leicester's games Leicester are thinking, oh, hold the back page here, guys. Look what we did to United over Maguire. We got 80-odd million for a player who we all know is only worth 30-odd million. We can do the same with Maddison. No player will leave our club. Nothing to do, we decide so. No, Maddison's not going anywhere. We love Maddison. Yes, we do. End of the season. Yeah, if you pay us 120 million, we'll let you have him. Absolute craziness. When it's because he's English, it's because he's a player who's wanted, it's because he's from a club who are coming in for him who they know have a lot of money. Let's be honest, which of the top teams would Maddison get into? Let's say the top six is without Leicester in it. Let's say the top four then. City, Liverpool, United, Chelsea, let's stick Arsenal and Tottenham in there, yeah. I'd say United is still a bigger proposition than Arsenal right now, and probably bigger than Chelsea. I think United are prepared to spend more money than Chelsea right now. Liverpool, way ahead of United. City, way ahead of United. Tottenham, probably on a level with United right now. Have I missed anybody? City, Liverpool, United. No, we haven't. Okay. Maddison would not get into the Liverpool team. He would not get into the Man City team right now. He'd get into the Tottenham team, he'd get in the Chelsea team, he'd get in the Arsenal team, and he'd get in the United team. Out of the four, who's a more attractive proposition on paper? I'd say United or Tottenham. Who is prepared to pay the most money out of them two clubs? Definitely not Tottenham. So it'd be United. United are a bigger club than Leicester, they always will be, and even if Leicester finish above them this season, United are still a better proposition than Leicester City overall. Will Maddison join United? That's another question. I think he would happily join them. Apparently he's a United fan when he was a kid or somewhere or other. Do we need him? We need a couple of decent players. I don't think we need to go and spend 100 million on one player. I think we need to get rid of Pogba and go and sign two or three players. Just hard working footballers before anything else. Get the hard work in there. Even if you have to drop down to the Championship, Dan James, bargain. Yeah, his form's dropped off. What a bargain price he was. This Calvin Phillips at Leeds, you know, one of the best ball winning midfielders in the country. Had a great game against Arsenal the other night. Go and get him in. 15 million, 20 million, whatever it costs. You just get some of these good young players in who want to work their backsides off to prove themselves. We don't need Pogba's. We don't need Maddison's 100 million. We don't need egos like we was after with Dybala. Forget that. None of that waffle is needed at United. Go out and get Cavani. Apparently he's end of the season. He'll be leaving PSG, Chelsea after him, United apparently after him. Get him in at United. An experienced striker is what we need right now. Has Pep's time come and gone? Now, I wrote this before last night. I wrote this a couple of days ago. And the reason I wrote this was because, in my opinion, he's allowed City to get a bit stale, a little bit aged. You know, he's lost company. He knew, even with company in the team, he needed another defender. He could not rely on Otamendi and Stones. Therefore, defenders, Laporte, Otamendi, Stones, company. Company was leaving. That left Otamendi, Laporte, Stones. He doesn't trust Stones. He barely trusts Otamendi. That just left one defender he could rely on other than Eric Garcia, and that was Laporte. Maybe he always had the idea of dropping Fernandinho back into defence. I don't know. But he's had to do it. And now when Laporte comes back, I think their back two will be Laporte and Fernandinho. Which might not be the worst situation ever for them. They weren't prepared to pay the money out of Harry Maguire. They needed a central defender. I just think his stubbornness got the better of him. And I don't see them catching Liverpool over the next couple of years. I think Pep will leave at the end of next season. And, I mean, do I honestly think they're going to win a Champions League this season? That is what they should focus on now. Champions League and Carabao Cup, FA Cup. They could still do a treble. But I don't think they're anywhere near winning a Champions League. They have Real Madrid, don't they? Who aren't fantastic themselves. They're not like classic Real Madrid. he's on the verge of kicking Pep's bald head up and down the pitch. Because Pep got a bit too cocky, in my opinion. Yeah, we'll win the league, easy. Season in, season out. We've got it ramped up. Before the season even starts, we've won it. Hasn't worked out that way, has it, Pep? What else we got here? Oh, yeah, also, he let himself get aged. David Silva. He's letting him just wind down the clock till he wants to retire. Fernandinho's 33, he was on 34. Sergio Aguero, he can't rely on, and Aguero's not the player he was 2 years ago because he's got older. Didn't really give Phil Foden a chance. What youngsters has he brought through apart from Foden and Eric Garcia? None. He's not given any a chance in the Premier League. And I just think it's really shitty on the City fans. They'd love to see one of their own in there. They had it years ago. Paul Like, I've read his book twice now. And he was one of their own and they loved him then. And they was like one of the last ones to really come through. They had Micah Richards and one or two others. But Phil Foden, they want to see that team week in, week out, and they go wait another to the end of the season before they can see it regularly. But then that's just one player. United at that time, Prophet Chong, James Garner's getting games, Brandon Williams, Rashford, Greenwood, you name it, United have done it. And Alfred City, what? Phil Foden, that's it. I was going to go through an FA Cup roundup, but you already know literally what's gone on. Let's go into the fourth round draw. Hull City take on Chelsea. Chelsea win. QPR win. Sheffield Wednesday. QPR win. Bournemouth, Arsenal. Bournemouth finally took the FA Cup competition seriously on the weekend. I could not believe it. Arsenal win. Northampton derby. Northampton win. Brentford, Leicester. That'll be a really good game. Brentford doing really well in the championship. But Leicester win. Millwall, Sheffield United. Millwall win. Reading, Blackpool. Reading or Blackpool taking on Cardiff or Carlisle. Well, we don't know who's going to be, so I can't give you a prediction. West Ham, West Brom. West Ham win. Burnley, Norwich. Burnley win. An all Premier League game there. Bristol Rovers taking on Coventry or Birmingham. Bristol Rovers to go through. Man City, Fulham. Man City win. Rochdale or Newcastle. What a great result for Rochdale on the weekend. Taking on Oxford United. Newcastle to get through against Rochdale, then beat Oxford. Portsmouth, Barnsley. Portsmouth win. Bristol City or Shrewsbury against Liverpool. Liverpool win. Southampton taking on Middlesbrough or Spurs. What an awful result for Spurs. It was a horrible game. I watched it. It was a disaster. Southampton to go through against either Borough or Spurs. Watford or Tranmere. Taking on Man United or Wolves. I'm going to go with Watford. They'll beat Tranmere away. I mean, what a game that was. Watford 3-0 up on the weekend. By the end of the game, 3-all. I don't think Nigel Pearson could believe it. Could Adam and Eve it. Anyways, what's his name? Yeah, Watford to go through. And then they'll be United. If it's Watford Wolves, Wolves will be out for revenge and they'll get the victory. And that's the draw for the fourth round. Now, transfer talk. I've got 6-7 rumours here. And they are only rumours at the minute. We're going to have a quick look at them. Wilfred Zaha swapped agents to Pini Sahavi, who works closely with Bayern Munich. There was apparently talks between Bayern and Palace, but nothing's expected to happen until the end of the season. Do they need him? Yeah, they need to freshen up their side. Callum Hudson-Odoi re-signed with Chelsea. He was, as we know, linked with Bayern. Leroy Sané been out injured since the beginning of the season. Bayern can't guarantee he's going to be fit when he comes back, and therefore I don't think they'll want to risk Sané. So Zaha, they know, wants to leave Palace. Will Bayern be too much of a step up? I think so. Look what happened at United. I can't stand Wilfred Zaha. I'll put it out there right now. I cannot stand the guy. And yet, he went to United. And I liked when he went to United, obviously. But he didn't do sod all for us, did he? And then went winching back to Palace, where he was able to be a big fish in a little pond again, rather than a little tadpole in a big lake. And flourished at Palace. But City. It's an odd one. Harry Winks of Tottenham. Do United need him? I think they need players. I don't think they need Harry Winks and the price that Tottenham would charge for one of their own. No way in hell do we want to pay that sort of money. And Man City? No, I don't see it. Xavi, I think it was said a while back, or was it Pep, one or the other, a few years ago, that the only player they'd take to Barcelona from the Premier League was Harry Winks. And this was when he was a young kid. I'm sure it was Xavi or Iniesta said that. Crazy talk. Eriksen to Inter Milan. Christian Eriksen. Well, I've already had my say on Eriksen. Well, I think he should be egged if he runs out his contract that goes on a free. Cavani to Chelsea or United. United definitely need this guy. Will we get him? Probably not. Chelsea will pay more. Danny Drinkwater assigned for Villa. He needs to listen to his surname a bit more and drink more water. He had half a season at Burnley, only made like a few appearances, and a long time out injured after getting attacked by a gang outside a club on a night out when he was pissed as a fart. Drink water, drink water. Listen to your name. Thomas Lamar to Spurs on loan. This is the Thomas Lamar Arsenal near enough signed from Monaco a couple of years ago. He ended up at Atletico Madrid, hasn't worked out from there. It's been a few of the years who've come to Atletico and it hasn't worked out.
I love the championship.
There's been a few players over the last couple of years who've gone to Atletico Madrid and it hasn't worked out, and Thomas Lamar was one of them. So he's been linked with Spurs on loan. Do they need him? Probably not. Spurs need a striker. And quickly, Harry Kane is out injured. Spurs need to go and get themselves a striker. Danny Ings is who I'd love to see them go and get. He's somebody who could come in, take the strain off Harry Kane, be scoring packs of goals for Southampton. Southampton are a selling club. We already know that. They're already pretty much safe in the Premier League now, thanks to Danny Ings. And I think if they got Danny Ings in, he could play regularly up until Kane come back, and then, you know, swap and change as and when the times call for it. Newcastle and Aston Villa apparently want Glenn Murray of Brighton. Glenn Murray, who has not really featured at all this season since, what's his name? You know who I mean? The bloke who is not the top number one striker at Brighton, was at Brentford last season. I had him on my FIFA game, scoring packs of goals. You know what I mean, anyways. It's going to do me a bit nice now. Let me have a look, because I don't want to be going away not knowing somebody's name and then remember it in a minute. Somebody else who's been linked to a move is Ademola Lookman, who left Everton for Leipzig in the summer. It's only been there 6 months and already he wants a move from Leipzig. Newcastle being linked with a loan move, with a looking at doing a permanent deal at the end of the season for him. But Newcastle fans are desperate to get in Alfredo Morelos from Rangers. Whether or not that happens, I don't know. Where are you? Where are you hiding? Neil Maupai, there we go. I knew I'd remember his name once I looked it up on him. So, Glenn Murray is really had a look in at Brighton under Graham Potter. Neil Maupai's number one striker there. And Glenn Murray's got a stack of goals last season for Brighton and the season before. And he's now been linked with Villa and... who else did I just say? Villa. Newcastle, was it? Yeah, Newcastle and Villa. Do both of them need him? They need a striker for definite. Another striker on his way out of a Premier League club could be Billy Sharp at Sheffield United. Strange one this. They are leading their top goal scorer ever at Sheffield United. But you know, dreamed to play in the Premier League with Sheffield United. Scored their first goal back in the Premier League with Sheffield United. And now finds himself out of favour there. And Chris Wilde is a ruthless man. He's prepared to get rid. So, see you later, Billy. That's me done, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know your thoughts on the football world. Whatever I've talked about, let me know. If you want to have an opinion on it, if you want to ask me any questions on my opinion on stuff, ask away in the comments below. Hit the thumbs up, subscribe, comment below. notification.